Hello, welcome to my winter Christmassy wonderland, full of joy for the body and the mind. lots of chocolate, lots of twinkly lights. Yeah, it's pretty much all you need, really. Chocolate friends, twinkly lights, and yoga. So I thought I'd make this little mini short video because a lot of people I know have got some issues with their neck, their wrists, their hands, RSI, carpal tunnel syndrome, issues with the neck and the nerves in the neck. So this seems to be a bit of a running theme, and I'm wondering whether all this working from home, sitting and looking at a computer in this kind of slouched position all day, is really starting to affect us. So I thought I'd just share with you a really just tiny little sequence you can do, maybe daily, in the morning, during the day, or in the evening, doesn't really matter, just to kind of reset and just to kind of find a little bit of awareness of your body, and to kind of open out the areas that get super tight and restricted around the neck and the hands and the shoulders. So we'll start seated, and you can really be in any position to do this, doesn't really matter too much. If you feel like you have been sitting down all day and you feel a bit tight in the hip flexors, front of the hips there, you could grab yourself a block and come to kneeling. So it might actually be quite a good thing for you if you've been sitting at a computer all day to sit in kneeling, because this will open out the front of the thighs, the front of the shins, the front of the ankles, and just a little bit through the hips at the front as well. So if this is really uncomfortable, just come back into a cross leg position, no drama. So first of all, let's interlace the fingers, and I just want to do something with you that I've really enjoyed doing recently in my classes, and it's called axial extension. Now this for me just helps me to sort of align my neck and my head. So if you interlace your fingers and place them on the top of the head, and then you want to kind of push the head up into the hands, so it feels like you're really lengthening and creating space in the neck. This is kind of like decompressing the spine. And when you're sitting in this position, for example, you can feel the curves of the spine naturally. You can sit up nice and straight. So just make sure that you're sitting up straight while you're doing this. Now, think about the shoulders moving away from the ears so you don't have this kind of hunched up feeling. And again, try breathing in to push the head up into the hands. And then breathe out to just let the shoulders melt down. And a feeling of grounding through the sit bones. So see if you can sort of ground your sit bones into the block. Now let's take the interlaced fingers to the back of the head and start to press the head into the hands now, so it feels like you're giving yourself a little double chin. Not too challenging for me over the Christmas period. Judging by the size of chips in this country. So press the back of the head into the hands, gives you a little bit of a double chin, feeling of like realigning the head with the shoulders. So if you've got a bit of a stoop in the head, this is a good thing to practice. And then let's release the head down towards the chest now, so you're getting this stretch for the back of the neck, and you can either let your arms dangle down or you can lift the elbows if that feels too intense, and just lift the top of the chest so it comes up around towards the chin, and this will give you a feeling of release all the way down into the shoulder blades, hopefully. So just have a little move about here, see if you can stretch out a little bit. One more breath, just letting the elbows drop down. See if you can create space through the base of the neck. Loads of nerve endings in this space. And then let's press the chest open to the sky now. Now the chest space, the pecs, get super tight when we sit at a computer all day. This closes off our breathing muscles. It stops us from feeling open around the heart space. It even makes us feel a bit emotionally closed off. So imagine this is helping you to really open out. And there are loads of nerves around the chest as well. And of course the immune system, it's important space for the immune system, so just feeling like you're opening that area up. Now I like sometimes, because my shoulders get tight, I like to move my arms over to the left, I'm mirroring you, take the right shoulder, a little bit more towards the center, the right elbow comes towards the center, and if you've got open shoulders you might be able to get your elbow to point up to the sky, a bit like cow face pose. If not, don't worry about that. Just take it to wherever it gets to. You might be just around the wrist or the forearm. Wherever you are, just press the head back, breathe into the right shoulder. See if you can open up that space around the elbow and the shoulder joint. Don't forget to focus on what you're doing and breathe. You don't have to force the breath or change the breath, but just make sure you are breathing. Pay attention to the breath as well to help you relax. This is a great way of relaxing, just noticing the breath. Helps you to become present let go of stress, which is probably the most important thing, really, if you're trying to relax your neck and shoulders, let go of stress. So changing sides, see what the left shoulder feels like. Breathing into it, notice what the deltoid, the top of the shoulder, feels like. As you breathe, think about just allowing more space to come to the armpit. This is a key space for the immune system, your armpits as well. Got lots of lymphatic glands in your armpits. Don't often think about them, but they are definitely there. And then let's press the palms up to the sky now. Open out the knuckles. Think about stretching the knuckles, the wrists, the elbows. This is a great stretch for the ulnar nerve. So you've got a really big nerve that goes from your brain through your arm. Got a couple actually, but the ulnar nerve runs along the top and can really get affected by tension in the connective tissues and the muscles, and our posture can affect this. So we want to open up the space for the nerves as well as freeing the muscles and the joints. Let's release the arms forward and down. Press the shoulder blades apart now. See if you can bend your elbows a little bit out to the side. Find a stretch by dropping the chin to the chest. You can have your palms facing in now. Imagine you're holding a beach ball. See if you can keep the elbows a little bit bent. Spread the shoulder blades apart, actively pressing them back, a bit like a cat stretch. And then work space through from the top of the neck all the way down into the shoulder blades and all the way across the back of the shoulders, pulling the elbows wide, finally into the hands. And then let's release the arms down and just give the hands a little shake out. So let's stretch the wrists and the hands a little bit now as well. So a little wrist sequence here. You can always change position if you're starting to feel like it's too much being in kneeling. Feel free to come to cross-legged. So let's try flexibility test for the wrist. So if you straighten your right arm, have your hand in line with your shoulder, flex at the wrist, and then hold all four fingers on that right hand, pull them towards you, straightening out the elbow, pressing the heel of the hand towards me or away from you. Try to press the shoulder blade out at the same time. Now, if you release the hand, just see where the flexibility is in your wrist. So if that feels really challenging, you might have weakness in the forearm, and this could affect your yoga practice, things like Chaturanga, plank pose. Now flex the wrist in the other direction, so point the fingers down, hold the fingers again, and just press the top of the wrist towards or away from you, and again press the shoulder blade back, so it feels like the whole space all the way down into the shoulder blades opening. Just notice how tight that feels, and you might want to press into the index finger side of the hand. That's the strongest part of your hand, and it's the area that will be feeling the tension the most. Oh, that's lovely. And then just to finish this little sequence, let's try stretching the side of the wrist. If you take your hand so your palm is facing in, bring your thumb to the inside, and then wrap the fingers around the thumb. Now imagine you're trying to pull your thumb off. Don't pull your thumb off, because you will need it. Pretty important thumbs. Just pull it down so it stretches the side of the wrist there. You might feel that. In fact, I'm getting a weird thumb cramp as I'm doing that, which is odd. But yeah, it should feel quite nice. And then releasing the hand, just pull the fingers really gently, give them a squeeze, stretch one finger at a time out, including the thumb, index finger and thumb, most important, and then really shake out that right arm. Let's do the left arm. So let's try the flexibility test now. Let's call it the plank flexibility test. Flex the left fingers to point up, so your elbow is straight and your shoulders are in line. You're kind of pressing the shoulder blade back. And then use your right hand to kind of see where the flexibility in your wrist is. So you're not just pulling your fingers, you're trying to explore how far back the wrist will bend. And then as you release, see if you can keep it there. Just see if there's enough forearm strength to keep the wrist in that position. It's worth knowing this, because if there isn't enough strength, you might be squashing the wrist joint when you're doing things like Chaturanga. And if you're letting your shoulders come too far forward as you do Chaturanga, that'll be really putting pressure on the shoulder joint. Worth knowing. Now let's press in the other direction. So flexing the wrist, you want to hold on to all four fingers but press them down now. And then try and work the front of the wrist, top of the wrist towards me, and the shoulder blade back so you can feel it. So remember, these tiny adjustments, you're going to feel them. You feel the pushing forward and the pressing back. Oh, feels so good. I'm doing my right side because I'm mirroring you, and I can really feel it's more intense on the right side. So you're probably going to feel that as well. Everybody's a little bit wonky. If you're you're not wonky, then you're probably some kind of weird robot from the future. So once you've done that, just shake it a little bit. Oh, that's so good. Now take your thumb to the inside of the hand, wrap the fingers around the thumb, and then just start to pull the thumb forward. So this is a stretch for the side of the wrist. And again, just work your attention into the outer forearm all the way up. And don't forget, there's so much going on. Your hands are teeming with energy as well. There's loads of meridian line points in your hands. And then let's try stretching one finger at a time. So just a little pull on the pinky finger, ring finger, middle finger, index finger, little thumb stretch. And then let's properly shake out. So now let's just try again, a little bit of a stretch for the front of the wrist, begging dog. I love this pose. You want to make nice tight fists in begging dog. Bend the elbows in and then really bend at the wrist. And then just focus for a moment on just rolling them, stretching them, massaging them. I like to call this chihuahua in a bath. Tickles me for some reason. Yeah, this can feel really good. And if you feel a tight spot, you can just stop and just have a little bit of a gentle persuasion into that space to stretch it more. Try the other side. And then again, just shaking it out. And then let's just stretch out the ulnar nerve. So this is a nerve flossing exercise. So you want your arms out to the side, you want your chest nice and open, you want your head back in line with your shoulders, and we're going to just bend at the wrists for this, so there's no bending at the elbows. In fact, see if you can really straighten the elbows out. Slide the shoulder blades away from the ears, and think about the crown of the head coming up into the axial extension. Now, as you turn your right palm in towards you and your left palm out away from you, lean the left ear to the left shoulder. So imagine you're trying to read something on your right palm, and you're trying to show the person to your left what's on your left palm. Now you come up to center and you're just moving in a lateral plane. So you don't want to let the head come forward or back. You want to try and keep the ear going directly to the side. Now as you move side to side with this, what you're doing is you're kind of pulling the nerve forward and back, or flossing it like you would your teeth. Gross. I don't know why I find the idea of flossing so gross. I think it's the word flossing, actually, just a bit rank, isn't it? Anyway, feels quite nice, eh? It shouldn't feel like a muscular stretch. It should feel like there's something going on with your nerves. Obviously, you get any pain or numbness or tingling, that's your cue to stop. Try one more on each side. You can pause at the end of the movement just to really explore it. You can kind of soften your shoulders away from your ears, kind of straighten the elbow a little bit more. Really stay present. And then let's release. Just give the shoulders a little shrug to relax the arms. Now, quickly, a couple of massage techniques. You can use a massage ball for this, or even a little tennis ball or something. It's probably easier, but if you don't have a ball, I'll show you how to do it with your fingers. So, left fingers, just squeeze the fingers together, and you're going to use the tips of the fingers as like a little massage technique. Now, where your trapezius muscle comes up to the top there, near your collarbone, so you should have this kind of gap in between your collarbone and your trapezius at the top. It's that muscle that gets a little bit too beefed up, and bodybuilders' necks tend to disappear when this muscle gets too big. So you know which one I mean. So you're basically going to get your fingers in to that spot where the trapezius muscle kind of comes up to the collarbone and push down and back. So down and back. So imagine you're trying to massage the muscle behind you. And just have a little sort of mooch about in this area, really. What can you feel? Is it really tight? I did this yesterday in a live class, actually. And it feels better today. I had a little bit of a self-massage. It was so good. So nice. And of course, if you find a spot that's tight, just pause, take a moment to let the fingers kind of melt into it. You can of course do this for as long as you like, and I really encourage you to move a little bit out to the side, go in towards the neck area. and then changing sides. I'm just making it short for the sake of this video, so feel free to take it as long as you like over this. So you're just kind of feeling around, and again, you can sort of kind of create some space in the trapezius area. Such a key area to focus on when you've got, if you get headaches or there's anything going on, you know, with your upper body, your immune system's not functioning that well, pay attention to this area of the body and give it a little bit of love. Do a little bit of self-massage and I guarantee it will help. So you have a little explore of that space. Take as long as you like over that. Then I always like to massage my neck. So just coming up to the space where your neck meets your head, give that a little rub down. Use your fingers to rub those knobbly bits coming down either side of the neck vertebrae. Don't often want to rub the vertebrae themselves because it's kind of rubbing on the bones, but just around the edges of the vertebrae and then around the side of the throat. You know, you can kind of give the back of the ear is a good area to rub into towards the bottom of the jaw, back of the jaw. Rub that space. You've got these big muscles here called the SCM muscles. They get really tight. So if it doesn't weird you out too much, you can give them a little squeeze. Feels really good. And then just finally, again, pause the video, spend longer doing this. Just around the chest, this is a great space to massage. So think about under the collarbone and then around towards the pec, the side of the pec, pectoral muscles, chest, around to near the armpits. Think about that space, give it a really good rub. Just notice that space is tight. You might not even really notice when you're practicing yoga that this is tight. And there's kind of areas that really massage gets into better than doing a yoga pose. So a bit of self-massage is great. So really work into that. You've got kidney 27, which is an acupressure point, and that's around this space in the collarbone, just kind of underneath the collarbone and above the top rib. So you can rub into that space as well. And this clears congestion, helps to boost the immune system, drops the energy down towards the hips. So stuck energy in the upper body. It's a really lovely pose for the winter because it relieves, like I said, congestion and kind of the effects of having a cold or indeed the coronavirus. So yeah, a bit of a lung boost. And then you can just tap the thymus gland, which is just behind the breastbone. So that'll help us boost the immune system as well. You can do a little arm while you're doing this. And then around the collarbone, give it a little tap. Oh, and then just carry on as long as you like, really. I hope this has been quite useful. I could go on for hours with these neck things, but check out my website for full hour-long videos. This week's video is all about the neck on www.notyouraverageyoga.com. But you can probably find all that information just below if you're on YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe and like the videos that I'm providing here, and I'm going to keep providing them for you because I aim to be of service. So if there's anything I can do for you, let me know, and don't forget to get in touch and have a lovely rest of your day. Look after Mr. Neck. Thank you.